Today we're talking about the never-ending well of joy that is Puerto Rico. Now, while most people are talking about how the government went full prices right on death estimates last year, yeah, I bet that houseboat and jet ski combo is $1. Nope, that is a big issue, but today we're talking about something I've been tracking since before Hurricane Maria ever hit. Government debt. Because for years, Puerto Rico's number one export was government debt. So they're saddled with more debt than someone who went to an out-of-state college. They were literally paying off debt by getting deeper in debt with other investors, something that would be considered a Ponzi scheme if it was being executed by a government. Now, in the past, things have not looked great for them. They were trying to file for a bankruptcy when a hurricane pretty much wrecked their entire country. Last time I checked in on them, they were still trying to raise money, but no one would give it to them without some serious fine print and a lot of high interest loans. Because, well, you were listening to anything I've said so far this episode, right? I think a better investment would really be the Kickstarter for the guy who wants to eat potato salad. Today though, it seems like there might be a light at the end of the tunnel, and good news, this time it isn't an oncoming train. So what is going on? It was just announced today that Puerto Rico's sales tax-backed bonds rallied after a tentative agreement struck in the island's bankruptcy promised to steer a large share of the revenue to owners of the securities. Alright, so a few things there. First, congratulations on finally successfully declaring bankruptcy. Three more times and you might become a respected businessman slash president. Who owns those bonds? Well, chances are, you do. Because pretty much all the mutual funds have invested in Puerto Rican bonds. Which is great. I mean, those guys had the discretion to invest in mortgage-backed securities with about as much risk as dating someone from Craigslist personals. So I really wouldn't put much faith in their discretion. Alright, so first, what is a sales tax-backed bond? Well, it's the thing you do when your bond rating is at the lower end of the junk pile. But you still need more money because your entire revenue stream is based on people not realizing you have no revenue streams. Now, people were losing interest in investing in general obligation bonds because the Puerto Rican government didn't really seem to respect the obligation in general obligation. So they started selling sales tax-backed bonds. So there were specific and designated revenue streams dedicated to paying off these newly released bonds. So, problem solved, right? Nope. Well, because this was like putting a dirty band-aid on a cut jugular. Maybe it helped a little short term, but it quickly made everything so much worse. A major problem of the bankruptcy was a battle between general obligation and Puerto Rican sales tax financing corp bondholders. Oh god, this whole thing was a mess that left everyone in one of the most bureaucratic Mexican standoffs. First, you had the general obligation bondholders who, whoa, did they have a pretty good claim on the money they owed. You see, Puerto Rico had so little buzz around their bonds that they had to make a constitutional amendment that they will pay back those bonds. So declaring bankruptcy is literally unconstitutional, which means, well, nothing when you're so broke you might not even be able to pay Supreme Court justices to debate it. Puerto Rico currently owes $13.3 billion in general obligation bonds to investors, meaning that it has more debt than any state besides California. And I suspect that California might be doing a little bit better right now. So investors are less likely to be paid in full than a Trump contractor. Alright, so next we have the $17.9 billion in sales tax-backed debt. Unfortunately for those guys, there's no constitutional amendment they can point to in order to legitimize their claims. Although they have $1.2 billion of revenue that's been frozen in a reserve account. Wow, when we're freezing one of our own municipality's assets, that's when you know we've left the realm of shady and entered into the realm of straight-up darkness. Alright, so yes, Puerto Rico has been putting a percentage of sales tax into account that would be used to pay off these newer tax-backed assets. Now that that's been frozen, investors in the tax-backed bonds can be guaranteed at least something. So now the third party in this Mexican standoff. You're probably wondering what that other group is. Well, that's Puerto Rico. They owe money to pensioners and, you know, just your everyday government debts. Unfortunately, those people don't have large New York law firms backing them up. Which is why you're seeing so many Puerto Ricans retiring to collect their money all of a sudden, in order to collect their pension before everybody gets the money. Which, again, is bad on so many levels for the Puerto Rican economy. Alright, so what happened in this bankruptcy case? Well, it's not good. Richard Ravitch, a consultant who helped take New York out of its financial crisis, said of Puerto Rico's bankruptcy negotiations, "It's like if you were writing fiction about how a government could f*** itself up totally in every respect, you couldn't do it more imaginatively than what's happening here." Sounds like a swell guy. What a New Yorker. Anyways, yes, this was a mess for the courts to figure out. So some of the details aren't public yet, but this was a huge win for people who invested in the tax-backed bonds, because owners of the bonds would get just over half of the future sales tax revenue they're currently entitled to each year. They would also get all of the $1.2 billion of revenue that's been frozen in a reserve account. Oh geez, that's all sorts of bad for Puerto Rico. Not only did they lose that money, but they're essentially having their sales tax wages garnished. Now, it's not the full amount that was allocated to them before the whole thing went belly up, but because investors have a hindsight of less than 20/20 and more totally blind, the value of these sales tax backed bonds actually went up, indicating that investors got more out of the bankruptcy. To the point where people actually looked at these defaulted on Puerto Rican bonds and thought, maybe I'll invest in that. See guys, this is why we continue to have financial collapses. I can't say I'm too surprised though, because if I had to place bets on who would win a legal fight between hedge funds and a small indebted entity, well, I think we all know how that one's gonna end up. So what happened with the general obligation bonds? Well, things aren't looking as good. Apparently, the Constitution is more of a suggestion. According to their 2019 budget, Puerto Rico's governor left $0 for bondholders, which is not great for those general obligation bondholders who scream about Puerto Rico's Constitution like they're tea partiers on a Latin American vacation. Not much has been reported about the deal between the bondholders and Puerto Rico yet, but it seems like some forces might be stronger than the Constitution. What can Puerto Rico do though, besides maybe insure the heck out of their country and hope for a hurricane, or fake their own death and change their name to Puerto Pobre on the next generation of maps? Oh, Puerto Rico owes you some money? We don't know them. We just moved in. Well, the best answer I could find is, and this is probably going to annoy half of you listeners and leave the other half cheering, but a combination of cutting entitlements and privatizing industry. A center-right research group, the American Institute for Economic Research, wrote an article saying, "The privatization of Puerto Rico Electric Power Authority will improve the power system on the island, and more importantly, will set the ground for market liberalization and revitalization of the island." Okay, first, tap on the brakes. Revitalization of the island? Yeah, okay. You're sounding like a beauty product that promises to make you look 10 years younger in a matter of days. Well, I've been using your product for months and I still don't look 14. I mean, Puerto Rico, the largest amount of your budget goes towards financing state-owned corporations, just as large as a section called General, which literally couldn't be less specific of a name. Puerto Rico did recently sell off their power company, although they maintain control of their electricity sources, announcing that 30% of electricity needs to be coming from renewables. But really? Sorry, but let's try to get full power before we start getting picky about that. Anyways, because of no money, Puerto Rico seems to be trending towards massive privatization. We'll be watching to see if anything changes, but until then, That's all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube, if you want to support nonpartisan comedic reporting, please subscribe to my channel and like below. Thank you for watching.